Today we're going to be learning about the sieve test, which is one of the most fundamental laboratory experiments to run in geotechnical engineering. After today's class, we'll be able to answer what a sieve test is, how we go about running a test, and why it's important. This last one is a key thing to keep in mind anytime you learn a new topic. Why are we learning what we're learning? Why are we doing what we're doing? So, a sieve test helps classify a soil at your site. So say you go to a construction site, you grab a scoopful of the soil at the site, and you take a look at it and you say, okay, do I have a gravel, do I have a sand, do I have a clay, et cetera, et cetera. The sieve test is the first step to help answer that question for you. The way it helps answer that is that after running a sieve test, you generate what's known as a particle size distribution curve. We'll get to that at the end. So before that, to actually run a sieve test, you have a series of sieves, and they are typically 6 to 10 inches in diameter, just a metal ring. So if we look at an elevation view, it's just sort of this circle of metal. But if you look down into the sieve, so if we look at an overhead view, you have a series of wires that form a mesh. The mesh can have really large openings and really small openings that you can't even really see by eye. And the way that we name these sieves is according to this mesh size here. So for a typical sieve, we have one called the number 4. This 4 means that there are 4 openings per inch looking into the sieve. So in this example here, this would be 1 inch. Because we have 1, 2, 3, 4 sieve openings. As another example, there's one that's called the number 200 sieve. This has 200 openings per inch to it. So comparing these two, the number 4 and number 200, which one would we expect to have smaller sieve openings? Exactly, the number 200 sieve. Because unlike the number 4, which has only 4 per inch, the number 200 has 200 that make up that same physical distance. Excellent. The reason why I bring up this numbering is because when you run a sieve test, you have a stack of 6 sieves, all with different mesh opening sizes. At the bottom of the stack, you have a pan, which we'll get to in a moment. And you order your sieves very specifically. You place the sieve with the largest mesh opening up at the top, and then as you work your way down, you have finer and finer sieve openings. The reason why we do that is because you have your soil specimen, and you pour it into the top of this sieve stack. You then place a lid on top, and you move this device into a sieve shaker. The sieve shaker basically shakes this tower of sieves for 15 minutes. During that time, particles are naturally settling and sorting by size. So with these larger sieves up here, larger particle sizes settle up at the top. And then as you work your way down, finer and finer particles settle on top of these meshes. Because if we think back to the ordering, coarsest opening here, finest opening down here. So really fine particles can make their way through these really coarse sieves until they get to a sieve size that they are larger than, so they cannot fit through the mesh opening sizes. There are some soil particles that may pass through all of your sieve openings, so they're smaller than all of your sieves here, which is why we have this pan to collect those materials. Are there any questions about the sieve test so far? Okay, 15 minutes are up. Now we're ready to start crunching the numbers. So you first want to individually weigh all of these sieves with the portion of your soil specimen that's retained on it. And the sum of the material that's retained on all of these sieves and in the pan makes up the total weight of your soil specimen at the start. Doing a few calculations, you get to what we're really after with this test, which is the particle size distribution curve. On the x-axis down here is particle size. Typically in millimeters. And then on the y-axis here is percent passing. Basically what that means is for a given particle size, there is a certain amount or a certain percent of your soil specimen that's finer or smaller than that particle size. Typical PSD curves have this backwards S shape, because we have larger particles here, smaller particle size down here. And so because we're working with a percent, we have 100% here and 0% down here. The shape of these curves will vary for a gravel, sand, clay, etc. And because of these different shapes, we can pull out different parameters. And from those parameters, we can begin going through the process of classifying a soil at a site. And that's the SIPS test.